It is Seek and Destroy Weekend. Yeah! And I don't have my guitar amp hooked up, so I can't give you some righteous riffs. But anyway, you get the idea. Unless you're really young and don't know old Metallica. Where were we going with this? My goodness. Okay, so where I'm at right now, I have done a ton of videos revolving around these tier 1 through 5 light tanks. I am really burnt on doing videos about one. So what we're going to do is, or tier 2 through 5, we're going to take a real quick look at these tanks, and then I have two funny battles to show you. The first is going to be in the Sexton 2, which is also half off this weekend. And I never play it, but I did play it last weekend with my friend Dan, because he's still at tier 4, so I was like, well, I'll take the Sexton out. And I had some fun, and we actually had one really good battle where I actually, well, you'll see. And then the second one, I have a surprise for you after that. So, anyway, we are going to go ahead and take a real quick look. What I think are the weaknesses and strengths of the T2 light tank. There's a Messerschmitt coming in the background. We might be in trouble. Is he going to fire on us? Nope, he's going to... Oh, wait, no, that's a Hawker Hurricane. My apologies. Okay. Did that look like an ME-109 for a second? Anyway, back on topic. I've obviously had a crazy day, and I'm all over the place. The T2 light tank. Mm-hmm. Personally, unless you're a collector or take part in those little black flag races that they do, I don't think this is a really worthwhile tank. The biggest issue is that it's a scout tank with a 260 view range. Somebody pointed out in my review video about a year ago, they're like, dude, you're saying it's a good scout, but really, it's not. It's terrible. Even with the upgraded optics, you're still under 300 meters for view range, so most people are going to see you before you see them. That being said, you know, if you like tier 2 and you haven't gotten any of the prize tanks, and here's this... the combat car, for example, the light Vic. These, to me, are all more fun on tier 2 than the T2 light tank. And the ironic thing is these are both giveaway tanks. They gave us to these for full free. And they're more fun than this guy. So, sorry, my invitations are going crazy here. It's Thursday. It's clan night. So I don't think this tank is really worthwhile unless you really have to have it. And there's people that are going to totally disagree with me. I haven't found a good rhythm for this tank ever. My biggest beef with it is that when you turn, it loses, like, if you make a 180 degree turn with this tank, if you're driving and you make a turn like this around, you're going to lose half of your kilometers per hour by the time you reach the other end of that turn. You're literally going to bleed off 20 or 30 kilometers per hour. It just does not turn well, and that makes you very vulnerable. It also doesn't accelerate that quickly. I'm used to playing some of the higher tier scouts, and I feel like, you know, obviously I'm used to that, so that it's not a bad tank. I feel like this for like 25 more gold is a much, much better option. This little guy can hold down a little bit. He's almost as fast. He has the same turning issue. He will slow down when you turn, but all in all, I think this is a better, a more well-rounded tank. Now, neither of these tanks get pref matchmaking. They're both going to see tier... Well, this one's going to see tiers 2, 3, and 4. This tank is going to see tiers 3, 4, and 5. But he has a much better view range, so you can actually use him as a scout. Still not great, but he is capable of scouting on tier 5. His gun is even capable of penetrating a couple of the artillery on tier 5. But he will bounce on some of them. So be ready for that, too. But this is a more fun, more well-rounded tank. Moving right along. Okay, the next tank is the T-15 light tank. This one turns really well. It's slower than both the M-22 and the T-2 light tank, but it doesn't lose as much speed when it's turning. And I think for a scout, that's important to keep rolling. I don't know. To me, this just feels like a more fluid tank. Now, the gun is about 10 pen lower than the gun in the Locust. So you're not going to... This is more of a pure scout. You're going to be scouting and really not shooting it much because the gun doesn't penetrate a whole lot of what you run into. It does not have preferential matchmaking. Once again, tiers 3, 4, and 5. But I'd say that this is definitely a thumbs up. The really nice thing about this... And somebody said that the M22 Locust, by the way, does fit the T-71 crew. That's pretty cool. Because then you can really use this as a trainer. The T-15 holds the Lux and the Leopard cruise. That's very beneficial. You need to be able to run your crews to train them. So right now my crew is, I don't know where my crew is because I think I sold my Lux or my Leopard. I'm probably going to buy the Lux back. I liked it better. Let's see, these guys, yeah, these guys are all Leopard trained, but hence, or look yonder and see that there is no Leopard in my garage anymore. I just didn't like it. So I'm going to go back to the Lux. Next tank, hold on. T-127. Thumbs up for sure. Half off. This tank doesn't go on sale as often as the T-15 and the M-22 Locust do. I'm not sure why that is, but it's only about two or three times a year that I see this guy go half off. This is a miniature KV. I'll tell you what. If you have the LTP and you like the LTP, this is just a much more buff version of the LTP. It does not... Or it does have preferential matchmaking, so it only sees tiers 3 and 4. And most tanks that you run against on tier 3 are going to have a very difficult time penetrating the tank. The downside is this is a very, not very, it is a relatively slow tank. It moves at about the same speed as an M4. So if you like the M4 and you're used to medium tank speed, that's what this does. So it's kind of like a miniature medium is what it is. I really like this tank a lot. It suits my style well. In fact, we'll take a look out of all of them. This is my favorite. If I had to pick from one of these tier 2/3 premium tanks, it would be this tank. And we'll take a look at the service record. 157 games, 56% win rate, 420 experience on tier 3. That's pretty dang good. So, yeah, I really, really like this tank. And it's fun. Actually, I'm going to be buying my kid one this weekend because they're on sale. So, this guy's an odd duck. This is a Lend-Lease tank. It is actually a British tank that was sent to Russia to be used by the Russians. It is classified as a light tank. I just want to point out that there are scout tanks and there are light tanks. Tanks that are scout tanks would be the M22 Locust, the T-15. The Panzer 1C. Definitely the T-50. My 5916, the Lux, those are all scout tanks. They were designed to move fast, not really have much of a gun, and combat the enemy, but not through gun usage, but through visual. So they would spot, obviously, and that really was their purpose. So then you have tanks like this, which, oops, like the Valentine II, which are classified as a light tank, not a scout tank. Another one would be, for example, the Kehoe. This tank is too slow to be a scout. The PZNA, I think it's PZ38NA. You know, the LTP. The Light Vic. Even though that's low tier. These tanks, oh, the T-127 for sure. These tanks were designed to support infantry and take out light armor. They were not necessarily designed to be scouts. So the top speed of this tank is very low. It's 32 kilometers per hour. You'll notice the crazy traverse speed of 50. So this thing goes wee wee. It goes back and forth pretty fast. It traverses very quickly. I can't do it. Forget it. You get the idea. There we go. Wee. It's a pretty quick turner. And it also is a very fast turret. This tank is very unique in that it has very premium matchmaking. Or very preferential matchmaking. It only ever sees tier 4. Unless you're stupid enough to platoon with somebody that has a regular tank. If you platoon with somebody that has a regular tier 4, you're going to get dragged all over the place. But if you play by yourself or with somebody that's running either another one of these or the PZB2, this tank will only ever fight on a tier 4 battle. And the reason being is because of this awful, horrible gun. Yes, it's a tier 2 gun. It has 51 penetration, 84 with the gold ammo. Sorry, I still have the cold, so I'm coughing. Not the greatest dispersion. Fast aim time, though. But this gun is bad. It is really bad. And it's a little bit frustrating because you're going to go against tanks. I'll tell you what. If you ever thought about getting a Super Pershing, or maybe even the Matilda 4, this is a good trainer for those tanks because it's going to teach you where to shoot. You are going to have to weak spot with these tanks. And even then, you're going to bounce shots. But it's an exercise in learning. And I have to say, I have a lot of fun with this tank. It's not the greatest tank that I own, but it's enjoyable. Let's take a look at the statistics. Sorry. Once again, 185 battles, 56% win rate. That's pretty good for a premium tank. Premium tanks are harder to get high win rates, especially when you're a chump like me. So, yeah, this has been a great tank. And it's been a lot of fun. So are there times when it's frustrating? Yes, but the armor is really good. So you have a trade-off. You got good armor, slow speed, crappy gun. But people are going to have a hard time unless they fling gold, and usually at the lower tiers they don't. If you angle a little bit, they are just going to be like, boink, boink, boink. I've gotten a lot of steel walls in this tank, so I definitely think it's a worthwhile thing. All right, so that's it for the light tanks that are on sale this week. So anything... These are all on sale this weekend. I think, to me, they're all worth half off, except for the T2. And even that, you know, if it were like half the price of the M22 Locust, I'd say, yeah, man, that is a great deal. But because it costs almost as much as the Locust, I'd say just get the Locust and be done with it. But if you really want to collect all the tanks in the game, like I did, I went ahead and bought this just because I could. I didn't need it. And after I had it, I'm like, I'll probably never play it much. Like I said, I have more fun in the combat car, the T7, so I just don't ever run the T2 light tank, but some guys swear by it, so, yeah. All right, so now let's take a look at something that I almost never take a look at, and that is the Sexton. Ugh, my mouse is freaking out. Hang on, I'm going to change my batteries. All right, so here's the Sexton 2. Now, I didn't give you really a fair review last time I did that, and that was a while ago. It's fun. And I apologize for making this a short review on those light tanks, but like I said, I've just done them so many times recently that you guys all know them. You know what they are. Unless you completely haven't been watching my channel at all, you know exactly what those tanks are. So, and on top of it, I've got this cold, so I'm trying to preserve my voice for the more fun stuff. I'm not a huge artillery fan. As you can see, these are the only two artillery that I have. I've got the LEFH, the 18B2, which is a great... Even I pulled this thing out this weekend and killed 5 people in one battle. This thing is just, it's a monster. If you ever can get your hands on one, if you haven't gotten it yet, man, when they go on sale or if they come on as a special, it's worth getting if you like artillery. Doesn't do a ton of damage, but it's a fast firing, comparatively, artillery. And they haven't nerfed any yet. Unlike the other tanks that they nerfed, they haven't nerfed this one. So, same thing for the Sexton. I'm sorry, it's not the 2, it's the 1. This tank is a little odd to me. If somebody could please explain to me why on earth you would use either... These don't have any splash damage. They give a little bit higher penetration and a little bit higher damage, but... why would you use armor piercing? I don't understand this. There's no... And I don't think there's any gold round. These are all... No, they're... Okay, so this one's gold. But... You almost never hit the target, so why on earth would you use armor piercing? Because you really need that splash damage to be lucky enough to hit stuff. But I guess you have so many rounds at 112, what does it hurt to carry it? I'm going to show you a battle that I had this week with this tank. It was pretty funny with my friend Dan. Like I said, I usually don't do great in these, but I've had a couple good battles this weekend with it. I don't hate it, but if we look at the service record, you're going to see a vast difference from what I've been showing you. Well, not really. 37 whopping battles with a 51% win rate. In fact, let's look just for fun. Let's look at the... Yeah, with this guy. Let's see. 43% win rate after 128 battles. Let's not look at that, maybe. Yeah. So I've actually got a positive win rate with this. I don't know how, but... it's slow moving. It's an artillery piece, you know. It has a good range. Honestly, for a tier 3 artillery, most maps you're able to hit the entire map from the lower back corner of whatever corner you're in. So it has a decent range. And it plays well. I mean, it's fast firing. It doesn't do a ton of damage, but like the LEFH, it has a pretty high rate of fire for an artillery. So I think every, you know, 10 or 11 seconds you're able to fire a shot off. That's pretty quick for artillery. So I'd say it's a good trainer. Definitely a good crew trainer. You see all these slots? I mean, you could pretty much fit any crew in there. So that's cool. You can, all the British artillery crews will line up with this. That's a plus. So let's go ahead and I'll run the replay for you. I think you'll like it. It's pretty funny. All right, Sexton in battle. I'm going to skip ahead, actually. Sorry. we'll get to the fun part. So here I'm in my sexton, getting ready to kill things, looking for targets that I can hit. And I'm so adept at aiming. I know you're supposed to aim past it, but I couldn't get any hits past him. So I thought, well, maybe I could break his track, and nope, it's gonna fall short. So yeah, change position. This was a loss, by the way, if I remember right. Trying to hit, aiming. I fired at him. But you can see how quick the reload is. I mean, it's not a bad reload for an artillery piece. So, I mean, I guess for people that like artillery, this would kind of be like the PAC-40, the FCM PAC-40, or maybe the T-127, or any of these, you know, premium tanks that I was talking about earlier, these low-tier premium tanks. If you like artillery, this is kind of like your equivalent of fun. Trying to hit this guy. I did hit him once, it looks like. There he goes. Got him again. Nice hit. 126. That's pretty much full damage for this tank. Unless you're really lucky. The damage can go upwards of 200 if you penetrate. My friend Dano's on the board with me. He's backing up. He's running the T-40. I didn't want to fire into our friendlies here, and I'm like, fire, come on, hit him. Yeah. Close. Splash damage. And our team is completely crumbled. I'm thinking, oh gosh. I've never once hit a tank in TD mode. I've never once been able to do TD mode and done it successfully. So I'm like, maybe if I switch back. Ouch. Ouch. But come on. Load. He missed. Oh! I'll make him hurt, that's for sure. I actually hit somebody using TD mode. And this is where it starts to get ridiculous. That's one. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, they've got me split now. This guy doesn't turn fast enough. I'm like, dude, that's... Hetzer's thinking twice now because he saw how fast I reloaded. He's like, maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. Well, I see this T-40. I'm like, well, I gotta make a decision. Oh, and he whiffs. Oh, and I whiff. And I'm like, well, no. Oh, well. Time to die. Oh, but look at this. Oh. Yeah. So that's probably the most damage that I've ever done in this artillery. Definitely one of the higher kill rates. I think at 4 is my most killed. But once again, I'm not good with artillery, but this is a good way, you know, honestly, playing at tier 3, that's probably a good way to learn it, you know, and get better at it. So maybe someday I'll continue down these lines, but I hate artillery so much, and I hate getting one-shotted that I really am loath to pursue this. So now comes a surprise. Dun, 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 dun. It's not really much of a surprise, but yes, I was stupid enough to buy this. I wanted more gold because I was below 3,000, and or just above 3,000. And I got it paid today from... You know, obviously, you guys have heard. No, I've talked about our financial struggles, and I got some good news there. I actually might be getting a job at a pretty big software company here in the Cleveland area. So, hopefully, that'll help us at least pay our mortgage. But I did get paid today from a client. I've been waiting for 2 months for over $3,000 from this client, and they finally paid today. So I said, well, you know what? I'm going to have a little fun. So I decided this was an okay purchase for the day. So for those of you who aren't on the boat or don't know what this is the Fury. I have one battle in this tank so far, and I won it, and I will show you that battle, because it went really well, and I'd like to show you my first battle in the tank. I did keep the tank crew, because supposedly these are the guys that are in the movie. I thought at first I was going to sell them, but then I'm like, yeah, you know what? that's pretty cool. I didn't realize, at first I thought they were just some random guys. But now that I realize, hey, these are the movie guys, that's pretty cool. It's kind of like a collector's thing. So I'm going to keep these guys and I'm going to run them. And they will end up probably just only ever running this tank, which kind of defeats the purpose. But I've already got the Super Pershing to train crews. And I've already got, you know, my Ram. I don't know where it went. There's the Ram. I've already got the Ram. And they hold the same crews as the Fury does. So I'm not really gaining anything training-wise by buying this tank. In fact, this is one of those purely whimsical purchases. If you don't have an American medium tank, and I'm going to say this, and people are going to bite my head off for saying this probably, but if you don't have an American crew training tank and you want a decent, fun-to-play medium, and you, your choices right now are the Super Pershing, the Fury, and the Ram, this is the most fun of the three. And how can I tell you that with only playing one game? Well, I've got this tank, the E8, which is basically the exact same tank. The Fury loses a little bit of armor, but the E8 doesn't have much armor anyway. This has 63 on the front of the turret, whereas the E8 has the regular, the non-Fury version has 76, so it's got like 13 more. Pardon me. But look at the detail. I mean, this is cool. Look at the details on here. All the little, the packs and like all the shovel kits and stuff. Like, look at the regular Sherman. Still looks good. You know, I mean, it's not bad. But this just has so much more detail. It's really, really sharp looking. And I love that, the Fury on the gun and all that stuff. So, but yeah. So, I mean, this is basically for those of us that want something special. If you don't have a crew trainer, once again, I'm going to say it again. This is probably the best of the three. The Super Pershing, I love now. I used to hate it, but I love it. But it is a nightmare if you don't know what you're doing. And it's a much higher tier. It makes more money, though. But this is a good balanced tank, and it's fun. The E8's already good balanced. This is a good, fun tank. So I guess why I'm saying that is if it's something that you're interested in and you want gold and you want a tank, because you're paying for the gold and for the tank. You're not getting a good deal, honestly. But this is... So far, it's a good tier 6 tank, and I think if it plays anything like the E8, it's going to be a great tank. And the fact that you make more money, it's great. So I'm very happy with this tank so far, and I think it's pretty cool. Once again, I've only played one battle in it, so this is not a review. I promise you, in the next 2 weeks, I will do a review of the Fury, and it'll be a full review, but I want to play in it for the next week or two, really hammer it out and make sure that what I'm saying is the case. Because this tank's only going to be on sale until December 10th. Once that comes and goes, you will not be able to get this anymore. So is it worth that extra, because you're going to pay double for it. But however, you get the gold, so you're not really paying $30 for this. You're paying like $17 or $18, which is what a tier 6 costs. Is it worth it? Is it that much better than the Super Pershing or, you know, the Ram? I can tell you right off the bat, it's already a more fun tank than the Ram is. But is it going to be more beneficial than the Super Pershing? Because honestly, the Super Pershing is only like $32. So, you know, between the two of them, which of these is better? And the Super Pershing makes a lot more money. But the Super Pershing also can be a very frustrating tank for people because it's a much higher tier of play and the gun bounces a lot of shots. So this might be a better solution. I think all around, this is probably the most fun of the three so far. But wait 2 weeks and we will say... For sure. Let's go ahead and run this guy in battle, and then we will clear out. It's my understanding, I'm going to jump ahead here, that the Fury does not get preferential matchmaking, so you will see tiers 7 and 8. However, this is the first battle, and I am in a tier 6. Notice the Fury on the other side, run by Wunzebel. I do love the detail. I did not camo paint this tank. I probably will at some point. But I don't want to ruin it. You know, I kind of like the... It's cool looking. But, you know, these mediums, it does help to have camo, so... dang it. Why do they have to make it look so good? I love the like the striping and stuff, and that isn't on the tank in the movie, which... It's pretty sweet. So... Got some more reviews for you guys coming up too. I finished a review on the KV-3. I also did a review on the AT-7 finally. Now look here, this is pretty decent gun depression. I am exposed though a little bit, more than I want to be, but that's really what I could do here. This guy makes a big mistake. Now, one of the things I love about the E8 is this incredible rate of fire. Doing about 130 damage every, 3 seconds is pretty wicked. I'm like, well, maybe I should move up. Try to get him from a different angle. Oops. And I whiffed. Crap. Ah, but the Wolverine. He'll make a good target. Ouch. Enemy is hit. That was stupid on my part. So once again, not a lot of armor. Critical hit. And for those of you that know the Wolverine line, the Wolverine is running the exact same gun that I'm running, most likely. He might have the M1A1 if he hasn't ground the second gun. But the Wolverine gets the same gun at tier 5. And it's just, it's a wonderful gun. One of the downsides of the Fury compared to the regular E8, it is about 8 kilometers, 7 kilometers per hour slower. It's not as agile. And then once again, it also has the thinner armor. So you're missing agility a little bit and the armor. But you know what? It's not bad.
Enemy armor is damaged.
It plays pretty much exactly like the E8 does. That short slope body helps you use these, hills for cover. I'm thinking, man, I need to change positions here. What is this dude doing? Hey, Seth. Yay! Oh! Not good. Not good. Kill him. Yeah, so he's almost killed me now. I'm just waiting. Oh! Bounced. Whew. So you can see, they've got a couple heavies. They're kind of rolling our team. And I'm doing my best to hold, but what on earth are these guys doing? What is this KV-1 and the T-150 doing? They're not in the battle. Oh well. The KV-1 got the Wolverine. I'm like, man. But it's okay because it's still a really even game. We have one less tank than they do, but they've got some small tanks, so. Our biggest tanks are still full of health. There you go. Missed that one. Artillery. You'll notice the nice gun depression on this tank is negative 10, same as the regular E8. No benefits there. Really, this tank reminds me a lot of the Chinookai. Or the Chinu versus the Chinookai. They're very similar tanks, whereas, because they have the same gun, oftentimes the premiums you get like a slower, heavier armor, but a crappier gun. In this case, it just pretty much is the same tank with a little less speed. Ouch. Stupid artillery. And that is the truth of the Chinookai versus the Chinu also. The Chinookai is a little bit slower. Everything else is the same. So I don't mind that combination. I think sometimes being faster gets you in trouble more often. So having a little reduction in speed actually can help you play a little better because you're not able to push out too far. It makes you kind of take your time. And I like that. That always makes me do better. So in this case, I'm doing pretty well. Now, the front of a tank, not with this gun. I'm thinking, he's probably going to shoot me. I better get out of here. Uh-oh. Whoa. He's got his eyes on me. Huh? What? No, I'm just, this is a replay. Yes, they do. Alright, this guy, I don't know what he was thinking. No, I told him it was a replay. This is my first battle in this tank. So these guys, now he's realizing, hey, I'm gonna go back and get that guy, but I don't. Too late. So far, not, you know, a stellar battle, but doing exactly what this tank is meant to do. And it did a good job defending, plus it's, you know, I got a little flanking in there and helped the team kind of stay, keeping the tables turned in our direction. I'm realizing, well, I probably should try to go back and help with these heavies. Churchill 3. Not a problem. T-150, that could be a problem. Yeah, and he's got pretty big armor, so I'm just getting out. Once again, that mobility, you know, it's pretty key in getting away from things like that. I'm just going to move out, get out of the way. Oop. Can't get the gun down. Nice shot, KV. Thankfully, he chose to hit the KV, not me. Seems like our team is having a really hard time with their artillery, but it's finally almost over. Here it goes. I'm not sure what the heavy is doing. He's just kind of spotting the artillery and then doing nothing. And their T-150 is owning our T-150. Our T-150 had full health. There we go. A little help from the back. All right, back to the garage. My son and I are talking about planets and how Pluto's no longer a planet. And just, that's a hard thing, man. 40 years of my life, or 30 some odd years, and it was a planet, and now it's not. And it's, but his little kit, he got a little planet kit for his bedroom in it.
A 3D solar system, and it glows in the dark.
It's a glow-in-the-dark 3D solar system.
If you look at the list of the planets, there they go. Pluto is at the bottom.
Yeah, Pluto's at the bottom because it's small, and it's not really a planet anymore. Anyway, so we saw the Fury in action there, and that's, you know, how I play the E8, too. So really, if you like the E8, this would be a great crew trainer, though. It has its own crew, so once again, that kind of defeats that purpose, but it's a good Tier 6 medium tank. You could put this crew in your barracks and run a crew that needs to be trained in it. So you don't have to train this crew, but I just thought since it was part of the kit, I think it's kind of neat, and I'm going to keep the crew. But anyway, so far it's a cool tank. So we will do a review of it in the next couple weeks before it goes off of sale again to see if it's something that, you know, you would consider buying. But I like it, and I'm happy that I bought it. So anyway, have a great night, guys. Be sure to subscribe, and I will see you all during this week and also next weekend. Bye.